think one of the most challenging aspects of treating cancer is the evolutionary nature of cancer itself. It's always trying to survive in any way, shape, or form possible. So we need to become extremely sophisticated and think three steps ahead in order to properly treat the disease. I was originally attracted to genome engineering because it's such an exciting area of research. The prospect of genome editing will actually impact all aspects of human life. The ability to change the genetic code of any organism, it'll affect the way we produce fuels and food and also treat diseases. The types of diseases that we're most interested in treating are the highly lethal metastatic cancers. There's very few cancers that once they've metastasized, they can be cured. We actually started a clinical trial for a pediatric tumor called osteosarcoma in 2018, and we have approval for another engineered cell trial that will begin in 2019. The resources available here at the University of Minnesota are very critical to our work. As a Big Ten school, they have lots of core facilities that empower us to do the work that we do and also allow it to be translated to the clinic in a relatively rapid fashion. One of the other more exciting things that I've been involved with over the last 4 years is a startup biotechnology company in Minneapolis called B-MoGen Biotechnologies. We actually learned a lot about being entrepreneurs and the different steps and procedures that you have to go through to actually start a real company. And luckily, we had the support of the University of Minnesota as we were a spin-out company, and we actually even licensed some intellectual property that we had developed at the University of Minnesota. I think some of the main driving factors that drove me into the field of genome engineering and cancer immunotherapy is really the lack of current therapies and just the exciting nature of being able to reprogram living things by manipulating their genetic code to really help human health and evolve society overall.